Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television for Monday, December 9th, 2013. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures and commodities are flat, so far we're looking for a quiet open at 9:30 Monday morning. Now, Friday turned out to be a rather exciting day at the open, and we came into Friday actually on some sell signals, including a sell signal for the S&P 500. Now, I heard from a lot of you Friday morning about waving off that signal and just sitting tight with your long positions, and I know that many of you did that. Some of you didn't do that, but on Monday, I really don't want to do very much at all. Yes, we did break out from Wednesday's range to the upside, but most of the buying was at the open, and didn't get a lot of fall through to the upside after that. We'll look at that in a second. Also, we're looking for the VIX to come back down and generate a sell signal here before we want to get overly bullish on the stock market. Now, if we go back to Friday morning's presentation, I did the video before the employment numbers came out. At the same time, the futures were up sharply ahead of the employment numbers. And so I was looking from Thursday's close, I was looking for a move up at the open to the 1796.88 level. And if that didn't hold, then of course there was psychological resistance at 1800. I wasn't really expecting it to move all the way up to 1804.69, but that is certainly what it did. And so at the open, you had a big move up to 1800. We stayed there for 3 hours, and then finally we moved up to resistance at 1804.69, and that's where we spent the day. So you had the overreaction at the open, and then you had some buying, which of course is bullish, going into the close. But the majority of the move was the overreaction at the open. And now we're in a little bit of trouble here because there's a tremendous amount of resistance up at this level. Of course, the next target is 1812.50, which is both an hourly and a daily target. But there is a lot of resistance between here and there. So the market might have to tread water for a couple of days before it starts to move up. Now, on Friday, we were looking for an hourly close above 1791.02, and we certainly got that at 10:30 in the morning. And then the market moved only a couple of points higher for the rest of the day. So on Monday, an hourly close below 1795.21 would certainly be a sign of weakness, as would a move down below 1800. Next up, let's zoom out and take a look at a couple of weekly charts. When it was all said and done, the markets basically closed close to unchanged last week. And so the excitement that we saw, the multiple down days in a row, the lows on Thursday, really doesn't show up as any sign of weakness on the weekly charts, whether you look at the S&P 500 or the NASDAQ, which closed up nearly 0.5% on the week. Continued selling in gold stocks, down over 6%. We saw some buying in crude oil last week, which took us back up into the channel and setting up for a potential weekly buy signal for crude oil. And then, of course, nothing going on in gold, down a little over $20 on the week. Next up, let's take a look at some of the NASDAQ most active, and Intel was the volume leader. Reversal day on Friday after the buy signal on Thursday. We gapped higher on Friday morning, tried to take out the previous high from a couple of weeks ago and could not do so. So I think we're going to have to fill that open gap before we can move higher. Looking at Cisco, the charts are really taking pity on Cisco as the channel lines move down to intersect with price, even though price isn't moving anywhere. A close above 21.45 would give us a buy signal on Monday. Facebook generated a buy signal 3 days ago, and we have not seen any momentum to the upside. So we just closed just above the upper channel line on Friday. Microsoft had an inside day on Friday, while Micron Technology continued to push higher. Looking at some of the NYSE most actives on Friday, the Spider ETF was the volume leader. So we had a sell signal on Thursday. We closed above the upper channel line on Friday. And so if you didn't take that sell signal on Thursday, hold tight. If you did take that sell signal and you sold at the open, just hold tight for a day or two and just see which way the market is heading next. Looking at emerging markets, they are now back on a buy signal as of Friday's close. Again, I'm not too excited about rushing in on Monday morning and buying a lot of new things, including the emerging markets. Looking at Bank of America, we generated a sell signal on Thursday, and on Friday we came in and traded in the channel, closing up 13 cents on the day. Looking at JCPenney, a sell signal on Thursday, continued movement to the downside on Friday. Inside day on Friday for a Rite Aid, no change there. General Motors continued to move higher on Friday, while Ford continued to move lower, down 4 cents on the day. Taking a look at commodity ETFs, copper was up 26 cents on Friday. Again, no interest in participating in copper at the moment. Gold had an inside day, platinum had an inside day, silver had an inside day, so no change in direction there. In the pre-market, they're all fairly flat. Crude oil, fairly flat on Monday morning as well, fairly quiet day on Friday. Inside day for gasoline, and natural gas traded up through our next price target, so hopefully you were able to unload some natural gas on Friday. Okay, folks, that's all for Monday morning. It's extremely quiet out there after being an extremely volatile day on Friday, and so if you have orders to put in this morning, there's really no rush to do so. You could probably sit on them for a day or so and wait and see what happens to the market next. There was a lot of overreaction at the open, not that much fall through to the upside, but we certainly closed positive on the day going into the close. But the majority of buying was done at the open, and I think those are people that probably did some short covering from going short over the last couple of days. But I don't see a lot of new money entering the market right now. Have a great day, folks. Next time we'll talk about the U.S. market is on Wednesday. Tomorrow morning I'll be back to talk about the Canadian market. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.